for the last 7 years, we've impounded close to over 90 tons of substandard products, and we've been keeping them here.
Fred Muzira, an official from the Crop Inspection and Certification Center in the Ministry of Agriculture, Animal Industry and Fisheries, has asked farmers to refrain from buying pesticides from hawkers.
They should desist from buying cheap things.
Can you look here?
They should desist from buying cheap things, because cheap things are not cheap. We always sell a story that somebody will come and reduce a price from the normal price by 2,000 or 1,000, and then you go and spray and lose all the other monies that you've invested in your land to plow the land, buy the seed, weed the crop. So when you add that, if you're buying a liter of 20,000 shillings and somebody's selling it to you at 18,000.
He has warned those dealings in the importation of fake animal drugs.
About 3.3% of the goods traded globally, not just agrochemicals. By the way, the leading counterfeit products are footwear, pharmaceuticals, and other things. About 3.3% of these products are global on the market, worth billions of dollars, are counterfeits.
Muzira says that they have managed to sensitize farmers and put up an enforcement team against use of counterfeit drugs.
So we argue them to just repent and come to the ministry as their godparent to make sure that they do the right thing and make sure that these things don't continue going. Because like you see, we are looking at things worth 2 billion shillings that will be incinerated at Nakasongola Army Barracks.
Slivia Nantongo, the senior agriculture inspector from the Ministry of Agriculture, Animal Industry and Fisheries, has said 10 culprits have been convicted and investigations are still ongoing.
Things are now going to change completely. Once you've gotten to deal in any non-compliance, actually you're now going to be stopped from operating an agro-input shop.
The collected pesticides were taken to Nakasongola Army Barracks to be destroyed.
Loading and taking these things to the Nakasongola Army Barracks for incineration, the permanent secretary signed off a contract to have these materials be taken to Nakasongola Army Barracks for safe disposal.
Story compiled by Godfrey Sempija for the news.